Hi guys, welcome back to my channel. Today I have a very exciting product that I want to review. If you follow me on my Instagram, you would have already known that I got the Kylie Jenner lip kits, and I thought that I should just make a very short video. This is part of my whole product review series, and this is not paid for. I bought this with my own money. So without wasting much time, let's get right into this. You guys must have all seen what the product is all about. There are so many reviews already on YouTube. It's getting more and more easier for people to buy her product, because initially it used to be sold out within, I would say, 3 minutes of trying. And right now I think she has changed the rules, as in per person can only buy 2 of her lip kits. And I think that's brilliant, because it gives more people a chance to buy her lip kits. And before, people were just buying it in bulk and then selling it on Amazon and on eBay for ridiculous amount of prices, which I felt was totally out of order. I got Dolce K, I also got Candy K, and I'm going to do a review of the Candy K much later, because I want to make this video very short and precise on Dolce K itself. Now, Dolce K, it's a very beautiful, subtle nude. That's exactly what I'm wearing at the moment. If I could be honest enough to say that I think I found my perfect nude, because it's a very unusual brown tone. But Dolce K, I can see why Dolce K and Candy K is always sold out. Those are the first two things from her old batch that people just go and rush and buy. I know she's got her new an orange shade called 22, she's got Mary Jo K, but it is mostly the very subtle nude tones and the pink tones that are her best sellers. If you see the box, I feel that it, the packaging of it, the way that it comes in her box, and as well as the way that the lipstick and her lip liner is packaged, it's very, very classy. I quite like it. I like the whole idea of her lips being embossed on it, and you know, it's a very nicely done you know, packaging, and I can see a lot of her time and effort has gone into, you know, getting her product look a bit more unique. When you open Dolce K or any of her lip kits, you get 2 of her products. One is the lip pencil and one is the liquid lipstick. I always felt that the ColourPop lip pencils were really nice and smooth when it comes to application, and it wouldn't get better than that. But I have to admit that when it comes to Kylie's lip pencil, it is the best lip pencil I have ever come across, because it is buttery smooth. The application is unbelievable. I don't know, if she could actually just sell this separately, and I think people would still buy it, because it's an unbelievable pencil. The pigmentation of it is beautiful, and I just love it. The only negative thing I could say is, because it is so buttery, it has a tendency to, like, you know, you need to sharpen it a lot more, because when you apply it, it just, you know, it just melts onto your lips, and sometimes you don't even need the liquid lipstick, and this pencil is good enough, because every lip pencil is true to the color of the liquid lipstick. So I'm quite loving the lip pencil. Also, I realized that when you apply the lip pencil and then you apply the liquid lipstick, it doesn't feel too drying, because the lip pencil is quite creamy, so it just, like, you know, makes the liquid lipstick settle quite well onto your lip. So I like the lip pencils. I'm quite impressed with it. On to the liquid lipsticks. I feel that when you apply the liquid lipsticks, it doesn't feel tacky. Two things I really liked and I noticed was, when you apply the liquid lipsticks, you don't feel like you have a liquid lipstick on initially. Yeah, it's not very difficult to apply. It applies really well. It's got a very nice color payoff, you know, when it doesn't go streaky. I'm not sure of how Coco K and the lighter colors would be, but Dolce K definitely doesn't come streaky. Talking about Dolce K, I want to tell everybody out there, it is not Dolce K, it is Dolce K. Dolce is an Italian word for sweet, like, you know, like sugary sweet. That's what they call in Italian, it's Dolce, and it's not Dolce. So I hope everybody just gets that right and stop saying Dolce, because that is so irritating. Okay, I have just completely deviated from that. About the consistency of it, once it's applied and it dries down, it doesn't have a tacky feel to it, which is really, really nice. About the about the dryness of it, I feel that this is a bit too drying. I have to be very honest with it. I have noticed, I thought that maybe it was because of the way my lips were the first time that I applied it, you know, that it was drying because I did not prep and prime my lips and, you know, just put a nice lip balm and, you know, the usual things that you do when you apply a liquid lipstick. But the second time that I applied this, I did put like my lip balm, and then I made sure that, you know, I didn't have dry, chapped lips. And then again I applied this and I noticed that it was drying. See, even now when on the inner part of my lips, I can feel it just drying up and almost like as if it shrivels up. So that is a problem that I've seen in the Kylie Lip Kit. Now, I don't know if it's only to do with Dolce K, because I haven't tried Candy K. I am going to do Candy K, a total different review, and then I will do a comparison between Dolce and Candy, and I'll tell you exactly which formula I like better. So another thing that I also noticed is when you apply Dolce K, it has a very liquid consistency. Now, if I have to compare the consistency of the Kylie Lip Kit, the one that comes closest to it is Lime Crime. Lime Crime is also very easy to apply because of how liquid it is. It's not like a moussey texture that you need to be really careful. And another thing, like Lime Crime, is once you apply it, it really sets for a long time. If I have to talk about the duration of how long this lipstick lasts, I'm quite impressed to say that it has lasted me for quite a while. I'm quite impressed that I wore this in the morning once when I went out, and by evening time it was still there. I would say that it faded a little bit on the inner side, like, you know, on the inner lip area, but it did not crumble or chip. Then, because I heard many people complaining about how it crumbles right in the middle, for me it has not done that. I feel when you apply it with a lip pencil and then you do the liquid lipstick, it is much better. Also, I have noticed the color in the bottle, it comes true to the color when you apply it at first, then all of a sudden it goes really darker than what comes across in this bottle. So if in this bottle it comes a very, you know, caramel brown, it'll go to a very, to a nice brown, I would say. It's not like very offensive, but it goes really darker. It gets darker and darker as hours go by. I do love the color, no doubt about it. I am going to now show you another similar color, a perfect dupe of this. Everybody knows that Beeper is the dupe of Dolce K, but I feel that there's just a slight difference. I feel Dolce is a little more warmer, but I will show you, I will swatch it on my hand and I will show you the difference between the two. Cannot, if you do not want to invest $29 on her lipsticks, which I feel it's not bad, because a MAC is quite expensive for just the bullet lipstick, but here you're getting the liquid lipstick and you're also getting a lip liner, which I feel it's, I mean, for her brand, for her name, $29 is quite reasonable. But if you want to just spend $6 and see exactly whether the color will suit you, then please go ahead and just get that, because that's exactly what I did. And when I saw that Beeper, I'm talking about Beeper being the perfect dupe for Kylie Jenner's Dolce K, when I saw that Beeper suited me really fine and it did not wash me out, I thought, okay, I do need Dolce K. So I'm going to show you the comparison of both. This is ColourPop Beeper. As you can see, it is quite similar to Dolce K, but ColourPop Beeper has got a cooler undertone to it and Dolce K has a warmer undertone. So I'll swatch and tell you. So this is Beeper. And I think once it dries, you guys will know, you know, whether it's similar or not. And this is Dolce K. This is Dolce K, and this is ColourPop Beeper. as you can see, it is a little bit similar. Now it is drying up a little bit, and like I told you, Dolce I feel is a lot more warmer, and Beeper is a lot more, it's got a cooler undertone and a hint of pink, whereas Dolce is your perfect caramel brown. I wanted to show you the swatch of the lip pencil, Dolce K's lip pencil. And like I was saying, it is very true to the color of the liquid lipstick. So that is why I love this lip pencil, because first of all, it is absolute butter. It goes on so smooth. I feel this is like the best lip pencil I have ever come across. I thought ColourPop pencils were great, like I mentioned before, but this is absolutely stunning. Very true to the color. And if you do not like a very drying formula, I feel that even if you apply just the lip pencil, that's more than enough, because it stays true to the Dolce K color. If someone had to ask me what I prefer, whether I prefer ColourPop Beeper or the formula of ColourPop, or if I prefer the Kylie Lip Kits, unless and until she has a color that is absolutely outstanding, like something that I have never, a unique color that I've not seen in any other liquid lipsticks having, or the reason that I thought Dolce K and Candy K were, I wanted it, is because I felt like when it comes to, I don't know, lately I have been really loving nude, you know, the browns and, you know, the nude lipsticks more than the brighter lipsticks. I mean, I love bright lipsticks, but I thought that Dolce K was beautiful, and no doubt that it's a beautiful, beautiful color. But is it my favorite formula? No, it's not. Also, I wanted to show you what I meant by the drying. As you can see right in the middle, it gets really dry. It's not tacky at all, but there is a, you know, a very, you know, it just like when you're, you know, when you go out in the cold and you feel a little bit dry, and then, you know, your lips just shrivel up. That's exactly what I'm feeling at the moment. Very similar to what I felt when I applied ColourPop Tule, but when I applied ColourPop Beeper, it wasn't that bad. In fact, it was a little tad bit better than Dolce K. Candy K might have a different formula, I don't know. That we shall find out in the next video. You guys will just have to tune in and stay around, stick around, subscribe to my channel and find out. So it is about 12 o'clock right now, 12:11, and I'll be stepping out another 15-20 minutes. And like I told you, every 4 hours I'm going to clock in, and I'm going to tell you guys exactly where this one stands, where wearability is concerned.
So a quick update, we just finished lunch at Wagamama. I had a very oily, spicy noodle, and this lipstick is still going strong. It has just chipped a little bit in the middle, and but it's still there, you know? Standing strong, isn't it?
God, look at my hair. But guys, just completely ignore the way that I look. I look as if something that the cat dragged in, but I just got home because I was showing my brother London, since it's his first visit, so we were like acting like a couple of tourists. It's about 8:30, and I wanted to show you how well the, you know, Dolce K stayed. As you can see, the inside of my lips, like on the outline here, it looks much more darker. Like I told you, as hours go by, her Dolce K looks darker. Something that you might like it if you're a fair skin tone person, because it'll look pretty alright with you. But for a medium skin tone, it can come across as being too dry, and also it washes you out. But this is a color I don't have, so I like it. It's cruelty-free, vegan, so that is a plus point. And it stays much more longer than any other liquid lipsticks I have. If this gets over, I think I'll be satisfied with just paying $6 for Beeper, because it is almost the same color. This is a beautiful color. I mean, it's a one-time buy for sure, because the packaging is beautiful. She has put in a lot of effort, and I'm sure she is proud of it, and she should be, because it looks pretty good. That I will like the formula of Candy K a lot more. I haven't tried Candy K as yet. I want to do a first impressions video very soon with that. I'm going to be doing the same thing that I did with Dolce K, hoping that will last as long as this one.
So yeah, that is my honest review of this product. I really hope you like the video. Don't forget to subscribe, follow me on Instagram, Twitter, Snapchat. Don't forget to like and leave a comment below and tell me if you have bought Dolce & K, whether you like it or not. Me, I can see how people are going crazy where color is concerned, but this overhype, I just don't get it. Now I look like death, so I better wrap this up. Guys, I love you so much, and I shall see you soon in my next video. Bye for now.